I'm recording a speech for August 17th, 2020, which will be the first day of classes at Warren Wilson College, where I teach. My name is Jeff Keith. We will not be having convocation, and I received a teaching recognition that comes along with the obligation or opportunity to address convocation. Since it's unsafe to gather in August 2020 because of the disease, I thought I'd go ahead and read a speech that I had already written. So this is the convocation address for the non-convocation for the fall of 2020. I hope you enjoy it. My goal was to write this speech on 2 pages, and I did. You're welcome, and that's true. Welcome to college. You are welcome here. College is a fascinating time in life, and these are fascinating times. Some might say that 2020 feels like the end times, but it isn't exactly, and it is sort of. I knew the summer of 2020 was getting complicated when an old friend reached out to me. I live on Warren Wilson College's campus, here in the Swannanoa Valley. This friend used to live on campus, too. Back in June, she said to me that she had really hoped that she would have had the chance to ride out the end times in the Swannanoa Valley. Completely, suddenly, all at once, and with great speed, I realized things were getting out of hand. That said, these aren't the end times, but these are sort of like the biblical end times, the so-called revelations. This is a time of revelations. My friend Matt Hoffman, a professor of religion here, sent me an article about this topic, and it is true. Revelations are in the air. People are realizing things completely and all at once. One of the main things that most of the people in this country are realizing is that everyone is a person. Some people are realizing suddenly that the people running large pieces of the federal government have no idea what they're doing. Some people are realizing with great speed that they are going to die, and that when that happens is out of their control. I arrived here in 2009, and most students at that time couldn't explain to me the significance of the Berlin Wall. They knew it had fallen, and they knew that this had to do with capitalism and perhaps democracy, but they didn't remember it falling. You, virtually or otherwise, arrived here in 2020, and most of you have a similar relationship to the fall of the Twin Towers in 2001. As long as you can remember living in this country, we have been at war. For that, I'm sorry. Someday, the students who come to Warren Wilson College won't remember when the world fell apart due to the coronavirus. And someday, you will need to explain to people younger than you who George Floyd or Breonna Taylor were, why they mattered, and why they always will. History helps us keep things straight, see? But it's a debate about the chaos of life, not a sing-song telling of stories about the past that makes us comfortable. The past, in fact, is offensive and disturbing more often than it is pleasant and comforting. It is full of revelations. But the further history gets in the rearview mirror, the easier it is to laugh at what were, in fact, terrifying realities. Put another way, history is complicated, but we, as people, make a cartoon of it for the sake of comforting ourselves or for making elementary school kids feel pleasant. Well, welcome to college. We're going to tell you news stories, and these stories will require you to think critically about the world and your place in it. Here's one of those stories. A man boldly stood up for his country's independence. He stood up in the face of an overwhelming foreign power and a history of colonialism. He played one groove off another, appealing to the French and to other countries for help. Finally, he believed he could establish a country from what had been a collection of colonies, but wouldn't be anymore. This man stood up in front of a crowd to say, "All men are created equal. They are endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights. Among them are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness." Some of you may think I just described Thomas Jefferson, or Alexander Hamilton, or some other dead white guy, but I just described Ho Chi Minh, the leader of what became Vietnam. Ho Chi Minh came to be considered a prime enemy of the United States by the leaders of the United States, but Ho Chi Minh saw himself standing up in defiance of colonialists who had no right to control the Vietnamese. Ho Chi Minh saw himself as a champion of liberty and justice for all. That's something else we'll teach you in college. Words matter. Their meanings matter. And maybe you have gone to a school like the school I went to. In my school, when I was growing up, they had us pledge allegiance every single day. We turned to the flag and pledged for liberty and justice for all. But here's the thing. Those words, liberty and justice, mean specific things, and they are not easily reconciled with one another. In this country, people are always fighting over liberty and justice. One wins out for a while, and then there's a revelation. Some people have been abusing liberty, taking him for all he is worth. But now see, justice has been hurting for a long while. A lot of people are realizing, suddenly and completely, and with great speed, that this is the case. And now we have to do something about that. I bet you have questions. Well, that's what college is for. We're going to treat you so many different ways that you're bound to like one of them. And then you can focus on that one thing. Eventually, you'll move on with a better sense of how you might make the world more just or free or lovely. This brings me to my final story, and it has very little to do with what I've learned on account of higher education. Rather, this last story is about the bedrock of who I am, and I hope it resonates for some of you. My mother and I were talking this summer. She and my dad live in the woods, and we often go out at the end of the day to watch the buzzards and hummingbirds as the woods glow with the setting sun. It is a great time, really. I love it. And my mom and I were talking, and she asked me about this talk. And she asked me what I was going to tell all the new students. I said, "I'm going to tell them that words matter." She nodded her head, leaned forward, and then settled back into her chair. She looked pleased about that idea. And that got me fired up to talk some more. I added, "Liberty and justice. I'm going to hammer home that we need to think really hard about those two words because they're so important." She perked up. "And love," she said. Then she looked at me and gave me some advice. "Be sure to tell them that love is what matters." As usual, she was right. Love is what matters. Welcome to college.